Today we will be bursting or barraging rock lobs. This guide will show you how I burst rock lobs. You will need to be on Ancient Magics. Here's the gear that I use. I use the Aura of Reverence, just to make prayer last a bit longer. Full Slayer Helm, Ardugni Cloak 3, Arcane Stream Necklace, Staff of Light, Arum's Robe Top, Arum's Robe Bottom, Tome of Frost, Barrow Gloves, Infinity Boots, and Ring of Wealth 4. Now your inventory should look like this, depending on if you want to be barraging or bursting. I'm just going to try bursting. I normally barrage with battle robes to save runes, but since my battle robes are degraded, I'm just going to be bursting with arms. Alright, so you'll need a few bursting casts. This should be 2k more if my Staff of Light activates and saves some runes. You'll want to have done Love Story or have your house at Relica. And ship a Relica tab if you've done Love Story quest. If not, just have your house at Relica. A house tab is a way to get out. Helm of Neotisnot, you know, Proselyte, a Ceridoman Brood just in case you run into some trouble, a Restore, you know, to boost your stats back up. An Enchanted Excalibur would help for heals as well. Rune Throne Axe. I'm going to bring an Extreme Magic Potion, but I would suggest a Magic Potion. One of each of the charms. And should be all set to go. Alright. I would suggest having done the quest as first resort, so that you can use the spas, but I just find it to be a bit more helpful. Longer run. So let's go to Mobilizing Armies, and let us start. Just to keep the gear from degrading. This is my first commentary guide. It'll be a pretty bad guide, but hopefully I'll get better the more I do. Alright, so we're going to hop in here to restore our prayer, as well as boost it. It's a good little boost on 089. We're going to hop in here so that we can run for a longer amount of time. It'll boost your energy. Oop, Zanuck. And here to boost our HP. Alright, so now we're ready to go. Our HP will be draining slowly, so let us begin. You may also want to join the friends chat, Bursting Lobs. If you need a door partner or bless, I would PM a rank in the clan for bless. If you die, definitely PM a rank for bless. So I will be right back. I'm going to try to get a door partner. Alright, we are back. So we are running to unlock these doors. There we go, and we climb down this iron ladder Then from here, you can begin to pray. I'm not good at this game, so I never pray. A lot of people like to rest right here, but since I use the spas, I don't need to rest. I can just continue on. And then we climb down this ladder here. Run over here. There's a ladder right on this wall. Up that ladder, then go down the ladder right here. Go up this ladder. You could rest there as well, but it's all up to you. And go down here, east and then north. Ugh, I don't like that. That needs to be fixed. That flashing screen glitch, but go up here. And this way, go down this ladder, we will continue on. We are almost there, in the home stretch. Here you may want to pray melee. And then down there, and we are here. So now it's time to find a world. Alright, now that we are logged in and we have found a world, we can begin gathering our rock lobsters. You may want to set your, well, you definitely want to set your quick prayers to melee, don't need turmoil, as well as protect item, just to be safe. Alright, let us begin luring the rock lobsters. I like to start over here, and I run around. Stand in this spot and wait for this guy to get past this little ledge here. That's going to be your lure spot. You're going to have them right there. So we run down here, like there. That guy can be a little bit of a menace, but you should be fine if you have the ability to use Soul Splint. Now you see, you get 401 HP. It is time to start bursting. Always make sure that you have your auto cast selected. So you don't want to get anywhere near these guys, especially if you've got battle robes on. They can easily just three hit. Alrighty. We've got our HP up. There you go. I'll do a few rock lobster groups. But here I believe we have 9 rock lobsters. Let's see. Yeah.
9 rock lobsters.
I suggest only having 9. You don't really need the last one down there. The soul split.
Rock lobsters.
We just flip on our prayer, collect our crimsons. Ooh, not bad. And then I like to run over here and stand in this spot right here. And then begin the luring process all over again. I normally average about, I want to say 200 crimsons per hour. 400 crimsons per trip. But that's with barraging. I'm not sure. I want to say I could get 150 or so crimsons with bursting. I haven't calculated it yet, but I shall after this trip. Also, very, very important, when you're luring, and you have any, if you have any Dagonoth on you, let's see here, let me around a couple Dagonoth up. If you have a Dagonoth on you, run to this spot right here. When you run up here, the Dagonoth will become stuck behind there. Not all Dagonoth will, though. Risking it there. Soul Split is so helpful here. Look at that. Three bursts, and I'm full HP. Oh, that's pretty much all you have to do. Let's see here. You don't normally get crashed here. Well, at least I have not been crashed. But if you do, the magic potion would come in handy at that time. You could use it at any time, really. Why not use it now? And don't forget, if you have the Reverence Aura, to activate that. It's also a good way of keeping track of how long you've been killing these guys. We switch over to that, switch that off. Grab our Crimsons. Green. Gold. About 1k... XP on XP counter equals one charm, one crimson charm. Alrighty. Well, hopefully this guide has helped you. If not, that's too bad. But if it has, you know, that's cool. Alright, and we're back just to show you my progress after about an hour. My hour has just depleted. Alright, so pretty much 1k XP on XP counter is equal to one Crimson Charm. Alright, well, best of luck with bursting and barraging. See ya.